A note on another year. In fact, it's my second Black Duck Polomon, second note on this film, because it is so intriguing, so challenging, I'm thinking. It's not a film that makes me feel good, but I think this is just the point, and just as well, we need to see films that are, of course, thought-provoking, much more than Avengers, Justice League. No offense, I have not even seen Justice League or Avengers or many of those mega productions that attract so much attention and audiences. But from what I gather, these are just motion pictures that may owe you in some way. I mean, it's spectacular. Creatures fight each other, and it's special effects to a superhuman scale. But what about the challenge to your thinking? They don't make you think, I think. And this does, because it makes you uneasy, it makes you feel emotions. I don't like Mary, for instance. She's awkward, she's stressed, she's tense, she's unhappy, she's a burden at times, she's overbearing, she's cruel to the girlfriend of Joe, and she's envious, but then her life is, if not a total fuck up, misery, failure, it's not looking well. She's telling a story in some instances to Joe, for instance. This guy abandoned me, and now I'm getting old and maybe getting too old. No, it's not. And she puts a brave face onto it at times. But beyond this, we can see that, first of all, there's solitude. And psychology has demonstrated that loneliness, isolation, is twice as dangerous as smoking. And we now know, we all know how dangerous smoking is. And think about it, this is twice as smoking, as dangerous. And I guess we'll soon have to have on TV, or I don't know in what places, horrible images. They have a campaign in Britain now where they show the horrors of smoking, a man dying because of cancer, and saying, I'd like to see my daughter, that's not to die before. But he dies before seeing that. So with a huge impact, meant to make you really abandon those who are still smoking after all this, should be terrified. Now, what about isolation? What images you can use for that? Well, they'll find publicity people, madmen, to refer to the series, are ingenious, creative. They'll find something. So, briefly, Tom is married to Jerry. Tom and Jerry, as a joke used in in the film. And speaking of this funny aspect, that's also phenomenal about this film. The fact that drama, intense drama, it's combined with humor, negativity, Mary and Ken are representatives of people who are lonely, people who are doing wrong things. Tembele. In the case of Ken, he's drinking, he's not exercising, he's gaining weight. And drinking again and again, and that's all he does. It seems the only exercise he's doing is take the beer, wine, whatever, to his face. So they're in some ways lost cases, but positive psychology can be used here, we can try and use. And there's a humorous, sometimes a British attitude to all this. We have Tom and Jerry, who try and help these people, both Mary and Ken. It's only so much that they can do, of course. Mary thinks for quite some time that she can hook up with Joe, son of Tom and Jerry. But that's not going to work. If he's nice, kind, friendly towards her, it's not in that sense. It's not sexual. It's not going to be intimate, which she thinks it might be. And therefore, it's hard to see a solution to this. And it's tragic because there's so many people in this position that maybe I'm not sure how old she is, but fast approaching or already past 50. And of course she can, I mean, there's always a chance. You can always hope. You have to be optimistic. You have to try. Learn to fail or fail to learn, as Harvard professor Tal Ban-Shahar would have it. But still, there's a lot of sadness in there.